USC goose.
All these girls in the club, I got my eyes on you. All these girls in the club, I got my eyes on you. All these girls in the club, I got my eyes.
This thing on?
Morphe, baby.
Take a sip real quick.
And then we gotta go in some ginger beer. Garbage with some ginger beer.
Hey guys, it's your girl Shade Jewel and I'm back with another video. So today I'm actually going to be talking about something new on my channel that I'm going to try out. I just got the idea. Let me not say I just got the idea, but God just planted it in my head just now to do it. So I'm just going to do it. I feel like I'm in a different phase of life where I'm trying to fix my mistakes, correct my path, and go in the right direction. And I feel like in order for me to be transparent and stuff like that, like, I need to be honest. And when I say I need to be honest, it's more of, if I'm gonna speak to you guys about something, I need to like expose myself in a way. So I feel like the stuff that I'm gonna talk to you about from now on are things that I went through and I grew from it. And for some reason, like today, it was placed on my heart to talk about gonna keep it 100, right? I feel like it was placed in my heart to talk about relationships, because if you know me, honey, I have a good amount of failed relationships. And I feel like the reason why I have a good amount of failed relationships is because, you know, honestly, I don't really know, because I'm not gonna say it's not me. Even though it's not me, but it's not me. I feel like when I'm in a relationship, I'm just very like, jump on it. Like, wanna do this, wanna do that. And I feel like I give out so much that it don't be given back to me. So I pour so much into other people's cups and it's leaving me empty and dry, because while I'm pouring in, nobody's pouring back into me. So, how do I want to put this? And I want to talk to y'all like sister to sister, because that's how I look at y'all. Like big sister, well, I'm big sister, little sister, friend to friend, woman to woman. Because at the end of the day, I have daughters and I'm looking at them and I'm just like, yo, I do not want y'all to repeat some of the same mistakes that I made. So it's like a lot of things I had to learn the hard way. So the first thing I want to talk about is dating older men. And like I said, when I talk, I'm talking from experience. So it's nothing that I haven't did or went through already that I'm telling y'all. Right? Keep it 100. I have 3 kids, right? Got 3 of them. All of them have to have a different father, right? So I have 3 kids, 3 baby daddies, right? Right? All of them are at least 10 years older than me, and one of them is 22 years older than me. That's not cute. It's not cute. And the reason why I say it's not cute is, for one, how do I want to put it? Because if, like I said, I live in my truth, I have 3 of them. You get what I'm saying? What I'm saying is not cute as far as like dating older men, because for instance, my first child father, right? I met him when I was 20. He told me he was 25. I'm like, okay. Come to find out that was a lie. He was 10 years older. My second child father, I met him when I was 23. I already knew how old he was. He was 45 at the time. I was 23. He was 45. That is the biggest red flag. But you know, me, I'm thinking like, oh, I got me an older man, da da da, like, I'm gonna be good, you know, because, you know, he make money and stuff like that. Like, I'm good. I don't need or want for nothing, which was true. I didn't need or want for anything when we were in a relationship. Now he don't do shit for his child. But it was cool at that time because my mind was like clouded. So when I say my mind was clouded, it was like he was kind of like controlling me with money in a way. Like punishment. You get what I'm saying? It was like a punishment. Oh, you ain't do this the right way, or you ain't do this like. All right, I was like trying to not say certain stuff, but the point of me making this video is to be transparent. So with him, I felt like it was a punishment with certain stuff. He wanted things done in a certain way and a certain manner and a certain time. With like, he tell you to come downstairs and I'm taking too long. It's a problem. Mind you, but he could be late for something, but if I'm late, it's a problem. Or he don't want to be talked to in a certain way. Like, he wants you to address him in a certain manner. Like, you got to know how to come at him, how to come correct. When it came down to him, I felt like I was walking on eggshells. Because, like, I don't want to piss him off and stuff like that. Still was like, you know, timid and stuff like that. Yeah, like, I felt like I was walking on eggshells with him. And he was a big money man. You get what I'm saying? A big, big money man. And, I felt like that's how he kept me in a way. I'd be like, you know, I want this right here. But with the hair, it's like what you need it for. It's hard to explain, but it was just kind of like he wanted to know everything in a way. And I don't care if he don't agree. I don't care if he's watching. I felt like he wanted to know everything in a way. So if he give you some money, he want to know what you need it for. When it came out to me, like when I wanted to get my body done originally, if he was paying for it, he wanted to tell me which doctor I was gonna go to. And he was trying to send me to Gold's Plastic Surgery. Anybody that knows surgery, they know you do not go there, honey, but. So I got my money up or whatever, and I got my body done by myself. Like, when I got my body done, that was an issue. Like, oh, where you get the money from, da da da, like. He gave me like the last $1,000, right? I told him I needed the last $1,000 to finish paying off my surgery. My surgery's already paid it off for. It was already paid off for. I used it to get like my massages and stuff like that. But he wanted to know what it was for. So like when he do something, he also like to throw it back in my face. He every time. Oh, but this baby father don't do this. Oh, but this person don't do this. Oh, this person don't do this, but I do it. Oh, boom, 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 boom. Like, it always was a comparison. And then on top of that, when he met me, he had three other baby mothers, right? And I hate that term. He had three other baby mothers and all his kids was in a different state. So, you know, I found out I was pregnant or whatever the case it be, had my baby, boom, like, yeah, he brought everything and stuff like that, as he should. This is your child. But yeah, just to go back on topic, I gave out like a little backstory, but with him, it was very like controlling. And I felt in a way he wanted to use me as like a trophy piece, because it's like, all right, he went to, the story's a little all over the place, but I get what I'm saying. So he went to prison, I think when he was like 16 or 17, and he came out when he was like 45 something. He served 26 years. So I felt like with him coming out of prison, and it's like, oh yeah, I'm gonna see if I still got it. Like, I wanna see if I still got it. Oh, I got me a young girl, da da da. And it's more like a mind control thing, because you know, anybody that was in his age bracket at that time would have been on some, you know, this need to be set, this need to be set, this need to be set, this need to be set. So when it came down to me, it's like, all right, she young. I could manipulate her or whatever. He was doing stuff for my daughter and stuff like that. My older daughter, he was doing stuff for her, like paying for daycare and buying pull-ups and stuff like that. But it all came at the cost of my mental health. When I say it came at the cost of my mental health, it came at the cost of my mental health. Because, honey, the stuff that man was doing behind closed doors and acting like he wasn't doing nothing and all types of stuff is insane. Like, insane. Insane. Like, even down to cheating and getting another girl pregnant or whatever. And then now he wants to play happy family and think that they're going to include my daughter in that shit after you disappeared from my child for 2 years? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. No. So, and God knows how long he probably was cheating with this girl or whatever the case it be. And I'm pretty sure she knew too. You get what I'm saying? Because I found it ironic that when he did pop up for them 2 weeks this year, he has showed me, like, I guess, like a collage that she brought him for Father's Day or something like that. My daughter's picture was in there. Why does she have my child pictures? Right? And at that time, my child, that picture, my daughter was two. Why does she have my child pictures? So that's neither here nor there. But the point that I'm trying to make is you have to be careful when it comes down to these older men, because they're preying on younger females to mind manipulate, mind control. It's all a controlling thing. And when I say the cost of your mental health is not worth some materialistic shit. It is not worth it at all. And I want to keep stressing that. It is not worth it at all, right? So now when it comes down to my son's donor, right? Gotta brace myself. Here's another one. 10 years, he's 10 years older. And I promise you, it's like, I feel like I'm 20 years older, right? With him, he is just a walking red flag. I wasn't gonna say it, but I'm gonna say it. When we first started talking, it came out of nowhere. When I say it came out of nowhere, I was like, do I like such and such? I said, I know I don't like such and such. Like, it came out of nowhere, right? So we're talking and I'm feeling like literally feeling a connection. And I'm like, this is completely different, right? Comes to find out, he told me himself around this time, and I still brushed it off like an idiot. He told me himself he went to a spiritual person about me.
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
I came straight from his mouth. He went to a spiritual person about me. So he put me under like some type of hypnosis or a spell, a love spell. I don't know what it was, but they did some work, and that's how him and I started dealing with each other. Because prior to that, I knew him for like 2 years and I never looked at him in that way, like, no, nothing. That's why it was just very sudden. And I remember I was on my phone. If I could call my sister right now, I would, but she's at work. I was on my phone with my sister one day and we just talking regular, and I came out of nowhere. I said, I like, she was like, what? I was like, and I was confused. I said, I like, she was like, what? I said, I don't know why I feel this way. Like, I don't know why I feel this way. Come to find out, he had this spiritual work, and they put me on like some type of love spell or whatever the case may be. But did that work? No. Nope. Free agent. It did work. It did work at the moment though, because when I tell you, when I say I was head over heels for this little guy, I was head over heels for this little guy. And I'm just like, I felt like nah, this is it. Like, this is it. And I say, this is it, this is it. But then I started noticing stuff after like the next year, like after a whole year go by, I start noticing stuff like while I'm pregnant and stuff like that. And then, you know, God has a funny way of like reminding you about things. Things that you should have paid attention to, and he just so happened to just bring it back to your memory. And you like, this where you went wrong, this red flag, red flag, red, like everything was a red flag. And when I say that, I'm gonna just say, like, for instance, when we first were talking to each other, he would tell me like about his daughter, right? And he was like, oh, you know, like he's so weird that he even described his child as like a completely different child. You know what I'm saying? That's a beautiful little girl, but he described her as like a total different child than what he described her as, you know? Thought it was weird. then he was like, oh, you know, like, this is my child mother, right? So he shows me this picture of this lady. So I'm like, oh, she's pretty, da-da-da-da, da-da-da. Like, all right, cool. That was not her. When I saw the mother of his child, that was not her at all. I don't know if he Googled it or just pulled it off of somebody's Facebook or something like that. That was not her. It was not her at all. And I just thought, like, it was very weird. This is something that God brought back to my memory about like a month ago. What else? Like, everything was a lie. Like, everything. He told me how he had, how he brought his parents a house. And he brought his parents a house or whatever. So I'm like, if you brought them a house, why are you at this place? You know, why are you at this place renting a room? If you brought your parents a house, he goes, like, I'm confused, right? I still, like, was rocking with him, like, when he was renting a room, I still was rocking with him. Let it slide, right? I just thought it was odd, like, if you brought a house, he like, oh, I brought the house over, we all used to live together. So I'm like, all right, so if that's your house, he was like, he brought them the house when he was in the military. So if you brought them a house, why are you left? I'm confused. Oh, you know, they was getting on my nerves, so I just left and I went and started renting the room. That don't make sense. Then what else was he told me so much stuff, like him. I'm gonna make a whole separate video about him, honestly, because I want to make sure, like, I bullet point everything so I can tell y'all from point A to point Z, honestly. Like, y'all let me know if y'all want that video so I can tell you from point A to point Z, and I'm not gonna hold nothing back. I'm gonna be 100% transparent. I don't care who don't like it, who feels some type of way, all of that. Like, I'm gonna give it to y'all raw, straight, like, uncut. So I don't want to make this video just about him, you know what I mean? But if y'all want that video, y'all let me know and I will let y'all, because he is a walking red flag. So if you guys ever come across this man, y'all better run. When I say y'all better run, okay? Better run. Okay? That's my warning. But, yeah. What else when it comes down to relationships, stuff like that? My second thing is, don't do wifey stuff for somebody that didn't even give you a title, or don't acknowledge your effort or your presence. So, like, me, for instance, I have a bad thing of when I'm in a relationship, I like to, like, cater. Like, when I like to cater, I love to cater. Like, that's my thing. I have kids. That's all I do, is just cater to people all day. So I enjoy, like, cooking and stuff like that. Like, I enjoy doing wife stuff. But sometimes it just does not work that way. Some people do not appreciate it until they don't get it anymore. And that's where a lot of people go wrong with me. Clock it. But clock it. Not to toot my horn or anything like that, but anybody that I've ever broke up with or just stopped dealing with, they always try to come back somewhere down the line, because, like, once again, not to toot my horn, but they always, not even trying to be funny though or be cocky, but they always try to come back somewhere down the line, because you're not gonna get what I give you anywhere else. So it's like, I feel like, how do I feel? I feel like I'm like a Lauryn Hill in the era of City Girls. That's the best way to put it. I don't like doing all of that rah-rah. I don't like doing all of that. You get what I'm saying? Like, I like to, like, if I'm with you, I'm with you. And any of my exes, they can tell you that too. Like, one of the funny thing is my first daughter, her father, he said, that's one thing. He goes, when you love somebody, you love somebody. And everybody know that. But I feel like I be loving people more than they love me. And that's where my biggest downfall is. So that's why, like, now I'm just taking the time to just sit back, relax, and drink my ginger beer. But that's what I'm taking the time to just focus on me, making sure my kids are straight, elevating myself and stuff like that. Yes, still deal with Leon or whatever the case may be. But we came to the mutual understanding from when we first started dealing with each other again that we just gonna let everything flow by itself, because that's when we went wrong the first time, as far as like we just jumping the gun with certain stuff, and it was like a lot of confusion and stuff. So I felt like that break, it gave us a good amount of time to figure out what we're doing, who we are, like relearn each other and stuff like that, and it's working for us. So nobody's jumping into anything, nobody's doing this, like we both just be chilling, right? What else I can say? Do not, I repeat, do not blow up these men's phones, okay? Let me say it again for the people in the back. Do not blow up these men's phones. And the reason why I say that is because I notice when we do that, they take it and they run with it. They like the thrill of knowing that they got you like feeling some type of way or like going crazy or something in their mind. Like, yeah, look at her. Like, yeah, I got her. Look at her. She fiending. Like, yeah, I'm on that. Keep calling. You know, laugh, looking at the phone. Looking right at the phone, just like this. Put the phone down. Don't do that, because I feel like I used to do that too much. I used to feel some type of way. One thing anybody will tell you, I used to call you down. You got your phone on do not disturb, notify anyway. I still do notify anyway, like my friends and stuff when they got their phone on do not disturb, because you telling me don't disturb you? Please. That don't apply to me. But do not blow up their phone, because I feel like they get a thrill out of it, as far as like knowing that they got you like mentally in a bind or something. And it's just, it's not worth it. You get what I'm saying? I do like a two-call courtesy, all right, you don't answer. Mind you, I don't do it anymore because I don't deal with nobody other than Leon, you know what I mean? And that's neither here or there. But I used to do the blowing up the phone stuff now, just in general, like, you get a two-call courtesy. You don't answer the second time, or mind you, and I barely call a second time. Honestly, I barely call a second time. But if I have to, you get a two-call courtesy. You don't answer, all right, like, I'm gonna wait until you ready to hit me up. And if I feel like I want to hit you up after that, I want to continue a conversation after that, then that's just what it is. But that's another one. Do not put all your eggs in one basket. And what I mean by that is, you just, like me, I am a very delusional person. Even still, I'm very delusional. Like I was the type, it's a different level of delusional I'm on now, but I was the type, I would fall in love in like 2 days. Like, oh, I start thinking about marriage and houses and all of this stuff we're gonna do. Mind you, I only knew you for like 2 days. But would I like say it to them? No, but this just like what used to happen in my mind and stuff like that. I was a very delusional person. And I just feel like if you're gonna be delusional to yourself. Don't let them know that you're being delusional, because they will use that against you. They will use that against you. And that's as far as like even with them cheating and stuff like that, because they know like you're riding, you're gonna stay, or whatever the case may be, they're gonna keep doing it. And that's what happened with my first daughter father. I was very delusional, stuff like that. Like, he was doing all the cheating in the world. Like, when I say all the cheating in the world, like, even when I was pregnant, and I still stayed because I was delusional as fuck, but the wrong type of delusional. So my advice to you, do not be delusional, please. What else? It's just so many things that goes on in my mind. So that's kind of like made this like a little series things, like a little sister to sister talk, right? And yeah, we just gonna go from there. we just gonna go from there where I just do like a sister to sister talk. But that's just kind of like some points that I wanted to throw out because I felt it on my heart to throw it out. I don't know if somebody may need this right now. I don't know, but I'm just obeying what was put inside of my head. So I made the video. Mind you, I just came back from food shopping. Thanksgiving is next week. But I just made the video because it may help somebody. And I think I'm gonna keep doing this. What's today? So today is Wednesday. I honestly think that I'm going to keep doing this every Wednesday, like just giving relationship advice, life advice, just different things. Oh, somebody knocked on the other door. I'm like, that's one thing, my hearing is 20/20, baby. Vision of 2020, my hearing is 2020. Yeah, I think I'm gonna start doing this every Wednesday, just giving out different advice and stuff like that. Just for people that need it, maybe some young girls out there, older women, who knows. But that's what I wanna start doing with y'all. And even if you guys wanna write me on Instagram and stuff like that, be like, hey Shadi, like how do you feel about this topic? And you know, sooner or later I'm going to, you know, invest more inside of my creativity and content creating, where it's like, you know, God willing, I can get my own studio, do my own podcast and different things like that. But for now, we in here, we are in here and my little shindig. Right? But yeah, we're gonna work our way up. We're gonna be consistent,
period.
But on a serious note, if you guys feel like you want me to address something or feel like you guys want to tell me something, let me know. Drop a comment. Inbox me on Instagram at Shade Jewel. Do not inbox me on Facebook because I use my Facebook strictly for people that I know, like friends and family that I actually know, because I just keep my Facebook private. But yeah, guys. Yeah, that's all. So we will be back soon. I'm definitely going to say next Wednesday we're going to be back with another video on Wednesday. And I hope at least this video could bless somebody with something as far as like a little background of what I was talking about and like some red flags and stuff like that. And that's about it. I love you guys and peace.
High volume.
Am I really that?